Early in the morning, if you're in a city and you see this brown haze on the horizon, that is pollution. And that pollution is largely from the trace gas nitrogen dioxide, or NO2, which we can measure from tempo. You can actually see it with your eyes. And so when I was in LA, there were days where there were mountains just a few miles away and you couldn't really see it. There was this haze layer in between. And then you might get a clean day at a different time. You're like, oh, there's mountains there. Or, oh, I can see this building over here. My name's Laura Judd. I'm a research scientist at NASA Langley Research Center. And I've been working the last few years by collecting airborne data that simulates what the tempo satellite will measure. Upon graduation from my undergrad, I got an internship with NASA called the Student Airborne Research Program. And during the Student Airborne Research Program, interns are able to actually go onto NASA aircraft and get hands-on experience with collecting data. And I was put into the air pollution group. And I had to live in Southern California, Los Angeles area for a summer and actually experience that there's air pollution issues out there. And the thing that motivated me the most is over the time period of, say, when I was just an undergrad through school, a lot of decisions were made probably earlier when I was in high school that were reflected through improved air quality over just a few years. And I saw that as very motivating work that you can actually make an impact that quickly. My background is in meteorology. The weather has always interested me. It wasn't necessarily air pollution. But when we were gathering these maps over cities and measuring nitrogen dioxide, which comes from emissions, combustion of fossil fuels, so our cars, industry, power plants, we can see where that's coming from. But then if you measure it throughout the day, you can actually see the movement through the atmosphere. And so we call it kind of visualizing chemical weather. While right now, satellites, we can maybe estimate how emissions are coming from big point sources that are kind of isolated or maybe a city scale. The hope is with tempo, we're going to be able to discern this neighborhood versus another and versus this industrial area. And that's something that we haven't been able to do.